Hi everyone. In this video, I want to talk about using the balance equation in process modeling. So, we'll talk about what the balance equation is and why it is important to our knowledge in developing process models. The balance equation states that the rate of change of a quantity, whether that is mass, energy, or momentum, is going to equal the amount in minus the amount out plus the generation of that quantity. And this should make sense, right? Let's imagine this box here and some amount of cookies flowing through it. The amount of cookies out of our box is going to equal the amount of cookies in minus the amount of cookies that are taken out of our box plus any cookies that we create within the box. Now, that was a bit of a silly example, but the point being, we use this equation to track our fundamental quantities, and it is how we tell our control system how much of something we have or how fast something is occurring in our system, like the momentum, for example. So, now that we have an understanding of what the balance equation is, let's think about how this could be useful in developing a process model. Let's perform a rather simple example. Let's create a simplistic process model for how quickly a bucket is filling with water from a tap. So, let's draw a simple diagram of our system, as this should always be our first step in any engineering problem. So, we want to track the height in our bucket over time as it fills up. We know our quantity of interest here is going to be the mass, as energy and momentum have no real relevance here. However, if we had some movement or temperature change, then we would need another balance equation for these two. So, let's create a balance for the mass of water into our control volume. So, we know that we have no flow out of our system, so that is automatically going to be a zero. The mass into our system will be the density, which is kilograms per meter squared, times the volumetric flow rate into the system, meters cubed per second. Together these give the units of kilograms per second. We also know that we will have no generation or consumption term here, as there is no water being generated or consumed in our control volume. Lastly, we need to determine the rate of change of our water term. So, the rate of volume change within our bucket will be the volume at some time, t, subtracted from the volume at some time slightly further into the future. Now, if we divide by our small increment in time, we can take the time limit as it approaches zero, and we get the first order derivative, the rate of change, of our volume within the bucket, which is almost what we want. Let's also recognize something. The volume of something can be found through the density times the area times the height of the liquid. Additionally, since the area and density are considered constant, they are not going to change with time, we can bring both these terms outside the time derivative. Lastly, we can divide out these terms, and we are left with the rate of change in our bucket's height all through our balance equation, which is pretty awesome. So, once we get the final answer like this, it makes sense that we should validate our answer, right? We could do this simply by assuming all but one variable in our equation are constants, and then alter the other variable and seeing if it makes sense. Through this, you can quickly understand if your newly found derivative actually makes sense. Here, there are only two time variables. However, this would work no matter how many time variables you actually have. So, let's assume that the area is constant. Then, let's say that we increase our flow rate into our bucket. Will this increase or decrease the rate of change in the height over time? Well, it will increase, which it should, and this makes sense. Additionally, we could ask what would happen if we decreased it. Well, then the rate of height change with time would decrease, which also makes sense. Lastly, what if we changed the area of our bucket and kept the flow rate into our control volume the same? Well, with a larger area, it would only make sense for the rate of change of the height in the bucket to decrease. Therefore, we can definitively say that this ODE makes sense. We could also perform a consistency check, however, this will be done in the next video. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of what the balance equation is and how we use it when we develop process models. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.